Carl hadn't taken notice of the footsteps? What if someone had been here before him? Right until that point, Carl had believed that the object of this crossbow hunting had been a ravenous wolf who was terrorizing the village. But as he noticed the height at which the bolts had been fired, he concluded that the beast had to have been as tall as a man on his feet, not unlike a gorilla. The thought was chilling. Carl had found what he was looking for. He needed to get back on the road. A quick glance at the scene was enough for Carl to know that a fight had taken place here. The visitors must not have sold their skin so easily, literally. Carl reckoned that the place was still inhabited less than 24 hours ago. His detective sense tingled, revealing to him, or was it the strong smell of wilderness in the air, that there were most likely two men. Pierre the Poacher Bleu was definitely not the one who lived here. Indeed, Carl learned earlier that the man had recently been shredded to death by, allegedly, beasts. There should be a rifle hanging there. Its owner may not be very far. Two blankets. There were doubtless two people here, Carl reckoned. The jacket was still soaking wet. The poor man had, surely unwillingly, had a taste of the pond's water not too long ago. According to the pay stub, that poor man was Alexandre Bleu. Seems like the elements showed mercy to those nice and solid-looking planks. Thank you. The door had been busted down violently, and a burnt smell filled the air. Half of the cabin had been consumed by flames. Carl surveyed the chaotic scene, noticing that someone appeared to have intended to use the furniture as bonfire fuel. Carl had no idea how such a mess could have occurred, but he knew it didn't bode well. This hunt was never ending. Carl hoped that the hunter had finally triumphed over the beast. Seems like this place was long deserted. Just one more move for Black to checkmate White. More materials were needed to stir up the flames.